Hi everybody, this is Kathy from Kathy's Cards. This is the part two to the puzzle, altering the puzzle pieces. The other one I did was cardstock. Now this one is to use paint. So, what we will do first is you get your puzzle piece, and again, even with the paint, it is smart if you sand it. Yeah, sand it a little, because then the paint will stick even better. And a lot of times, you know, you can get away with just one coat, which also, I did mention this in my other video, but a lot of times if you can go along the side of your puzzle too, it gets off all that little extra little stuff that, you know, little tears and stuff that accumulate. Now, the paint I use is, I get this at Michael's. It used to be at Michael's. I think now you got to get it at Joann's, but you can get it at several places. It's Ceramic Coat, Delta Ceramic Coat. Usually you can get away with one coat, and I did get primer, but I found out when I did my other one that I was okay without primer. So, we're going to do that. I'm going to try it without primer and see what happens. Again, when it comes to paints, I usually have my wipes with me because no matter how I try, I don't know about you girls, I end up getting paint on me one way or another. It's hard to hold a piece of wood unless you got some special instruments, so I always have a baby wipe nearby. And then basically, you know, after you sand it, take a smaller brush again, because you don't want to, again, have the paint overflowing. And it seems like, you know, if you kind of do the paint in the same direction, you know, that it comes out smoother. And we will see if we need two coats. But basically, it was dripping along the side. It's almost impossible not to have it drip. Like I said, some of you might have a little contraption to hold your stuff, but I don't. So it gets a little messy. But like I said, I use the wipes for that. Just kind of go along. See, like I said, I get a little bit here, so I just wipe it off. Around my fingers, and I'll do the sides at the end. Usually what I do is I'll probably do one more, you know, one more quick coat. Like I said, I have found, you know, I didn't need the primer. I bought it and everything, and I did it on one of mine, but if you have the right paint, I mean, this is an expensive paint, But I got some other acrylic paint, and it was real thin. It was terrible. It didn't cover it. I had to do, like, quite a few coats, which, you know, nobody wants to have to deal with that. And you don't want to wait forever to get stuff done. And if any goes over to the side, just kind of blend it in for now. And then what you can do is, with the painted ones, I like to paint all around the edge so it all kind of, you know, blends in and you don't have any of the wood showing. Yeah, it's just me. Again, you don't have to, but, you know, I like to do this. Like I said, don't really have anything to hold it. Like I said, it's a little messy with the paint, but yeah, what's a little paint? It's water base, and yeah. So you get a little bit on you. Let's see, that looks like it's going to hold pretty good here. I think that's going to cover okay. Just doing it a couple times. Now, what I would normally do is I would wait for this to dry. And then you're going to do the other side, okay? You're going to paint that. I prefer to paint it because, again, I think it just looks better. So you would paint both sides just like you saw me do. And right now I'm going to put this aside. And I did one last night. So that would be at least dry. So I don't have to pause it right now. So I did this one last night. And what I did too is, yesterday when I showed you the cardstock one, I wanted to put a hole in the wood to have something dangle. And you should really do that. Like this one's all dry. Okay. I used my little puncher here. I know there's a technical name for this. But I used this and went in and punched the hole in there. And it punches it really good. I kind of find putting the punch in, before you start decorating, works out better. You can do it before you paint. It's no big deal. But, you know, put it in, then you don't have to worry about it. Now I'm going to clean off my brush here real quick. And then when it's dry, this is where the Mod Podge comes in. I'm going to pour some in. Pour a little in there. Try not to get it all over. Get my fingers in it. Which I'm great at doing that. Okay, so we got the Mod Podge. So now you put the Mod Podge on, not only because it'll help hold whatever picture you're going to do on it, but it gives it that nice, you know, that nice shiny. I put that on. And probably because it's going to take probably about a half an hour to dry, I'll probably pause after I do this. And I'll come back again after it's dry, and then I'll show you what to do next. And I could paint it ahead of time, but I couldn't really do the Mod Podge ahead of time and show you. It takes a little longer with a smaller brush, but you know, you don't get so much of it all dripping all over the place. And like I said, right now just concentrate on the front. And while it's wet, this is my preference anyways, I grabbed one of those little dresses that I like to make. And the Mod Podge is going to hold this down. And you can, it even gives you a chance to kind of move. But get this on while it's wet. Give it a few minutes here. You know, if you got a little, take the back of your paintbrush, if that'll help. Sometimes these little things. You know, just kind of make sure it feels like it's sticking. Now you can take paper, you can do just about anything to make sure it's down. Post-it note. Now just put a little pressure. Don't worry about getting some of the Mod Podge because it's going to go on the dress anyways. So now what you do, now that you got that down, you're going to put, and I might do my bigger brush right now for this. Okay, what you're going to do is Mod Podge whatever you colored. I colored this dress with Copic. And Copic seems to take Mod Podge fine. It doesn't seem to run or anything, so that's my big experience is with Copic, so I cannot speak for anything else. And it dries clear, so you know, even if you get a goop here or there, you can't get it all, but it should, like I said, dry nice and clear, and then you can continue on. So I would just leave that right there, and then I'm going to pause, and I will be back. Okay, looks like the Mod Podge has dried, and just a little hint, sometimes if I don't want to wait overnight, I have this little handy dandy. It's a very old fan. I got it at Walgreens, but I'm sure you can find them anywhere. It's battery operated, and it is great at drying the Mod Podge. You can dry it like within a half an hour. So that's kind of what I did now. But if you're not in a hurry, you can just do it overnight. So anyways, this is dry. There's only a couple spots, but nothing sticky. It's up to you. Sometimes I will Mod Podge the back, but that's totally up to you. If you do, you'd have to do that now. But again, then you'd have to wait, or you can just leave it blank because nobody really sees the back. But again, it's totally up to you. But I do more concentrate on the front. So now that I got this, I was trying to think of what I could use. In fact, you know what I need, guys? I need my glue stuff here. So let me get my glue bag. Okay. Someday. Oh, goodness gracious. Okay, well, I'm not going to waste time looking for it. I did have it. I put it away, so I wouldn't lose it, but here we go again. Where I put it, I don't know. So we're going to have to wing it, and hopefully I don't burn myself too much. Okay, so I thought maybe, I love these little acrylic roses, so I'm going to try. Have a little dot on here without getting burned. You don't want too much because then it kind of globs. So what do you think? You think that looks kind of nice in the middle? Figured I would do that. And now I don't know. I've never used these before, so I'm experimenting here. It might look stupid. I don't know. But I wanted to bring some blue into it too. So, I was thinking maybe along the side here, I'm going to try. Let's see, do I need? I don't need the little dots there. So, let's hope this is all together. And hopefully, it all sticks real nice. I think maybe I'll put the blue there. No, we'll give it a try, right? I'm just trying to think of something different to bring it all together. And cut this one. Same thing. Don't need here. Just cutting the right amount. I'm so glad these are together. Sometimes these type will separate. Bring that down. Okay, take some of my paint with me. Now that wasn't supposed to happen, guys, but hey. We'll cover it up. You won't know. Guess those really stick good. Alright. Cut one more. I don't even know where I got these. I'm sure somebody was nice enough. Or I got them on sale someplace, one or the other. Okay. And then one more. Let's see. Da, 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 da. It's funny how you get things sometimes. Like when I got these, I thought, oh, where the heck am I going to use these? But then you never know what you're going to be doing. Trim this. Got a little extra goop there. Alright. Get this on right without losing my paint. Oh, what do you think? Well, looks pretty good, huh? Now, let's see. What else can I think of putting on there? I don't want to put too much on. You know, I'm really not sure if I want to mess with anything else. Because then it might be too much. What I'm going to do right now is I'm going to leave that alone. It's got a word on it, so, you know, I really don't want to put any more words on. So I think what I'm going to do is, since I got a hole down here, I'm going to show you. Actually, this is my husband's. You know how you get these, you know, and then you got to open them? It's one of these special pliers, and I didn't know how to open them. So I guess you just go real slowly, like that. Hopefully it's big enough. Then you put it in there. And then supposedly I can put this back on and squeeze it. Let's see how I do here. Been wanting to do one with a hole. Fingers in the way here. Anything with fingers. All right. There you go. Got my hands covering it. I'm sorry. What I'm doing is I'm squeezing it to close it, which I know a lot of you jewelry girls probably know all about, but let's do that. Maybe then you can see better. I'm getting there, guys. One more time. Just not good at holding these. There we go. See, it closed. And that's kind of cool. See it? Well, camera's not working the right way here for me. I can't get used to this. But see how that hangs? Cool how it hangs. I'm so sorry at this angle you can't see. And again, like I said, if you don't have something to put the hole in, you can always glue it to the back like I showed you in the other video. Then, let's see here if I still have it. I don't know how everybody else is, but I have a great way of losing so many things here. Oh, God. Okay. I did have a magnet a few minutes ago. Oh, here it is. Oh, I found it among my mess. And then the last thing, what you would do, like I said, I might decorate this a little more. I don't know. I'll think about it. But at least this gives you an idea of what you can do. Then on the back, this works real quick, is you'll take your glue gun and you'll put glue on the back of here. Not too much. I mean, enough, but you don't want it gooping out. And then you just kind of go for the middle. It seems, and get the little bigger size, you know, like there's those tiny ones, and those just don't work. But these are awesome. They just, see that? It's already glued on. So already you can put this on, and it's done. Again, I might do more to it, but I'm just trying to give you an idea. Like I said, the painting one just takes a little bit more because you have to paint, then you have to put the Mod Podge on and wait for it. So it just takes a little bit more, but there's so much you can do. Like I did a picture, I painted it, and I put it on. You can also, before you put the Mod Podge on, you can stamp and then color. A lot of people do that, or they'll put, you know, other things behind it. In fact, I got some pictures here I'm going to share with you. Put this aside, and I want to show you. Here's some more examples of things that people do, which I think are pretty awesome. Put that there. And here's another one. And see, you can put all kinds of stuff. And here's a baby one. This is a cute snowman one. This has got a key. This one here. Hope you guys can see him okay. And then I haven't done this yet. This is interesting. Somebody took two puzzles. He probably would have to glue them real good. And then did a stamp and then painted. So, I mean, you know, I hope this helps, guys, and I hope I haven't confused the situation. Like I said, you can go into so much more detail and do so many more other things, but I just wanted to kind of give you an idea. I've never done them before, so if I can figure it out, anybody can figure it out. Okay, guys, I hope this answers any questions you have, and I can't wait to see what everybody comes up with. So thanks for being patient with me, guys. Bye.